Yan. So welcome to our next lesson, no? So another solution, no? Or let's say solving, no? When we are talking about differential equations, so let's talk about elimination of arbitrary constants. So general rule, no, when we are eliminating arbitrary constants, the number of arbitrary constants determine the number of times that we are going to get the derivative of the function. So kung doon sa ano natin, doon sa nauna nating lesson, no, on solutions to DE, ang sagot natin is proving lang, no? Basically it's a function, no? Dito ang sagot na natin is a differential equation. Okay, so dapat yung mga differential equation natin does not possess or does not have the arbitrary constants that we have eliminated supposedly, no? So sige, let's try, no? We have here our first example. We have y is equal to ax squared plus bx plus c. So let us determine first, before we proceed with the differentiation, what are the arbitrary constants present in the function. Okay, so first we have a, b, and c, no? So these are our arbitrary constants. So meaning, tatlong beses natin kukunin yung derivative ng ating function para ma-eliminate natin tong arbitrary constant na ito. So we have y prime, no? Let's get the derivative. Y prime, what is the derivative of ax squared? So a is a constant, no? So we have power rule, so we have 2ax, diba? Then plus b, so bx, kapag kinuha natin derivative in respect to x, b na lang yung may iwan. And c is 0, so makakancel na natin yan, no? So dalawa na lang yung hindi natin na eliminate. So let's proceed with the second derivative. We have 2ax, or 2a rather, 2ax. 2a, no? Bakit? Derivative of x is 1, basically. So, 1 times 2a is a, no? So, 2a rather. Then, we have b, constant, no? 0 na yung kapag kinuha natin yung derivative. Then, we have our third derivative, no? So, the third derivative of 2a is essentially 0. Kasi constant na yun, eh. Diba? So, we have here our final answer. Y triple prime is equal to 0. Okay, so that is the solution, no? Yun yung, ay, hindi solution, that's the answer, no? So, by eliminating the arbitrary constants that we have. Okay, so next, we have our second example. We have x cubed minus 3x squared y is equal to c, no? So, let's determine ano yung mga arbitrary constant natin dito. So, obviously, x and y are variables, no? So, hindi sila kasama. Then, we have c as our arbitrary constant. Sir, wait lang. Constant din si 3, ah. Hindi ba siya kasama sa bibilangin? Okay, so guys, we are talking about arbitrary constants, ha? So, arbitrary constants meaning it is a constant but it changes from time to time. Diba? It changes depending on the situation of the function. Ang 3 kasi, kahit anong mangyari sa function, 3 na yan. No? So, hindi siya arbitrary constant. Fixed constant siya. Okay, so hindi natin to kasama. So, C lang yung kailangan natin. Okay? So, isang beses lang tayo magde-derivative. No? So, game, let's do this. So we have 3x squared minus, no, so lagyan nyo na ng grouping, product rule tayo dito. So if you can remember, no, sa product rule we have ito ka nalagay, no, you have two functions u and v, kinuha natin yung derivative. Okay, so this is equivalent to u prime v. U prime is the derivative of u, no, so in respect to x, no, so plus v prime u, no? Yung kabaliktaran naman, yung second function naman yung ating kukunin yung derivative, no? So in this case we have two functions, no, we have 3x squared at saka yung y, no? So kayo bahala kung ano i-assign niyo, no, pero para hindi na kayo malito, I suggest yung una na yung u, yung pangalawa na yung v, no? So u prime v, what is the derivative of 3x squared? So obviously that is 6x, di ba, times yung v natin is simply y. Then we have plus, no, we have what is the derivative of y in respect to x? So obviously that is dy over dx, ba? Or y prime, no, pwede din naman y prime, pero I will put dy over dx na lang para hindi na tayo magbabacksub later. So we have, multiply lang natin sa u, that is 3x squared. Okay, then of course the derivative of the constant is 0. So, ayusin na lang natin yung sagot natin, no? So, we have 3x squared minus 6xy then minus 3x squared dy over dx is equal to 0. So, kapag ganito guys, no, na nasa first order yung ating differential equation, we need to express this implicitly. Hindi siya pwede naka-explicit. Actually, pwede naman, pero mas okay siyang i-set into a rather implicit form. No? So, gagawin natin, magmumultiply ako ng dx para mawala yung dx dito sa denominator. No? Parang, we're just treating the derivative algebraically, kumbaga. Okay, so, therefore, we will have 3x squared minus 6xy multiplied to dx minus 3x squared dy is equal to 0. So, this is our final answer. Ayan. Okay, so I hope you guys understood, no? So, madali lang to. Basta alalahanin nyo lang yung mga differentiation rules natin, no? So, wala pa tayo sa calculus 2. Actually, puro cal 1 pa lang to. Ayan, okay? Next, we have y is equal to c1 plus c2 e raised to 3x. So, obviously, we have how many arbitrary constants? We have 2. No? So, c1 and c2. So, let's try to solve, no? First derivative. The derivative of c1 is 0. So, hindi na natin siya ilalagay. The derivative of c2 e raised to 3x is 3c2 e raised to 3x. Kasi nga, di ba, the derivative of e raised to u, kapag kinuha natin in respect to x, is, ano? eu du. Di ba? So, yung du natin dito is yung 3, kaya siya naging 3c2 e raised to 3x. Then, we have our second derivative, kasi dalawa nga, di ba? So, ganun ulit. No? So, 3 times 3 is 9. So, we have 9c2 e raised to 3x. Okay? Start with lang. Hindi natanggal yung C2 ah. Diba? Unlike dun sa nauna natin na natanggal yung C2 dito, hindi. Diba? C1 lang yung na-eliminate natin. So, paano natin gagawin yun? You can use the other derivatives. No? You can eliminate, no, by elimination, by substitution, no. Pero let's say ako, no, since meron na akong 3C2 dito, 'di ba? Actually, yung 9C2 e raised to 3x, no, this one is actually equivalent to 3 times 3C2 e raised to 3x. Eh, meron na akong 3C2 e raised to 3x, ah, di ba? Yung y prime natin. So, pwede ko na siyang i-substitute. So, we have y double prime is equal to 3y prime na lang. Okay, kasi 3C2 e raised to 3x na yung y prime natin. Eh. Ito yun. Ito. Ayan. Di ba? So, lipat ko lang sa kabila para naka-standard form tayo. So, we have y double prime minus 3y prime is equal to 0. This is our final answer. No? So, you can also use elimination by substitution, no? So, kayo bahala, pero mas madali kasi ito eh, mas mabilis. So, ito na lang yung ginamit ko. Okay, as long as you will arrive with the same answer, wala tayong problema doon. Next, we have our fourth example. We have y sine x minus xy squared is equal to c. So, obviously, we have only one arbitrary constant. So, once lang tayo magde-derivative. Okay, so again, product rule tayo dito. So, y sine x, no? So, this is u, no? This is u, this is v. Yung naka-double underline, yun yung v natin. This is u, this is v. So, we have u prime v. So, what is the derivative of dy in respect to x? That is dy over dx times sine x, di ba? Then, plus, yung baliktad naman, no? So, the derivative of sine x in respect to x is cosine x, di ba? Cosine x times y. Then, we have ito, yung second function natin minus. Ganun ulit, product rule ulit, no? So, u prime v, no? So, the derivative of x in respect to x is 1. So, 1 times y squared. Then, we have plus yung baliktad naman. So, the derivative of y squared in respect to x is what? No? That is 2y prime. Sir, paano siya naging 2y prime? So, kung babalikan natin, no? So, we have dito na lang y squared. Diba, this is in the form of u raised to n. And kapag kinuha natin yung derivative ng u raised to n, this will give us, lagay ko lang para mas maayos, ayan. This will give us nu raised to n minus 1 du. Diba? Ayan, ganyan siya, essentially. Oops. Tayo. Ayan, n minus 1 du. So, we have 2y raised to 2 minus 1 y prime. Diba? So, y prime is dy over dx, essentially. So, yan, 2 minus 1 is 1. So, 2y, y prime. Or 2y, no, tanggalin ko na yung y prime. Kasi nag-start na ako sa dy over dx. So, gawin ko na lang siyang dy over dx. Ayan. Okay? Then, this is equal to 0. Kasi yung c naman, no, is 0 kapag kinuha natin yung derivative. So, we have sin x dy over dx plus y cosine x para mas maayos lang tignan. Then we have negative y squared. Okay, negative y squared minus 2y dy dx is equal to 0. So sabi nga natin, katulad dun sa isang example natin kanina, kapag nasa first order yung ating differential equation, ilagay lang natin siya ng implicit form. So magmumultiply na lang ako ng dx dito. Okay, so we have sin x. So, actually, no, makakancel yung mga dx natin. Tapos, malalagyan ng dx yung mga walang derivative. Or walang dx, essentially. So, we have sin x dy plus y cosine x dx minus y squared dx minus 2y dy is equal to 0. Tapos pagsamahin nyo lang lahat ng may dx, factor out nyo yung dx. Lahat ng may dy, factor out nyo yung dy. So, therefore, our final answer is, so, sulat ko na lang dito sa baba. Unahin natin yung, kay bala ko, ano yung mauna, no? Pero ako, unahin ko na lang yung dx. So, we have y, no? Kasi, ito yung ating may dx, no? Kung mapapansin ninyo, ano common sa kanila? Y dx actually, no, not just dx, pati yung y common sa kanila. So, factor out yun na yung y. Y, cosine x minus y dx. Okay, then yung kabila naman, we have plus sine x minus 2y dy is equal to 0. Ito na yung ating final answer. Okay, so kahit magkabaliktad sila, okay lang, no? As long as same yung mga makikita ninyo, no? Ang hindi lang pwede magkabaliktad, of course, yung minus, no? So, yung cosine x minus y, hindi siya pwedeng maging y minus cosine x unless nasa kabilang side siya, no? So, pero dito kasi hindi siya pwede. Okay, so, yun, that's for example number, ano to? Number 4. Na example number 5 tayo. So, we have, usog ko lang. Senta, matatamaan. Gusto ko lang guys ha. Ayan. Tapos ito, gusto ko rin. Ayan. Okay, so we have here our fifth example. We have x is equal to c1 cosine omega t plus c2 sine omega t. So, determine the arbitrary constants. We have c1 and c2. So, 2 times tayo mag-derivative. So, we have dx over dt. This is equivalent to what? No? So, what is the derivative of C1 cosine omega t in respect to t? That is, what? That is negative omega C1 or C1 omega, kahit magkabaliktad, okay lang. No? Kasi omega is the numerical or rather constant na naka-attach kay t. So, kapag kinuha na derivative, yung constant na lang yung may iwan. Cosine omega, rather sine omega t. Diba? Then, plus C2 or plus omega C2 cosine omega t. So, sir, saan ba nang galing yan? So, kay cosine, diba, nasa form siya ng cosine u. Pag kinuha natin yung derivative, so this will give us, what? Negative sine u du. Diba? Yung du natin, yun yung omega. Okay, yun yung omega, yung du natin. Then we have sine u d over dx. This is equivalent to actually cosine u du. Okay, again, ganun din. No? Yung du is the derivative of the internal function. So, next, let's get the second derivative kasi dalawa yung ating arbitrary constant. So, we have d squared x over dt squared is equal to what? So, the derivative of sine, no, is positive cosine nu. So, we have negative cosine or rather negative omega squared kasi omega times omega will give us omega squared c1 cosine omega t minus, kasi diba cosine, derivative ng cosine is negative sine nu. So, minus omega squared c2 sine omega t. So, yun, nakuha na natin yung dalawang derivative. Now, sir, hindi na eliminate yung dalawa. Mas malala pa dun sa una, no? At yung una, C1 lang. Ito, pati C2, hindi na, pati C1, hindi na eliminate, basically. So, paano tayo magpo-proceed with this? So, kung titingnan natin, no, gagamit tayo ng, again, sabi ko nga, gagamit tayo ng other functions na nasa ibabaw. So, kung meron kayo mapapansin, ano kaya yung similar dito sa term na to? At saka sa term na to? So, sige, pag-isipan ninyo. Yes, tama, no? So, yung negative omega squared. So, pwede natin siya actually i-factor out. So, we have d squared x over dt squared is equivalent to omega, rather negative omega squared multiplied to c1 cosine omega t plus c2 sine omega t. Ano mapapansin ninyo dito sa dalawang, dito sa naka-parenthesis? Diba that is our given, the value of x. Meaning, we can substitute this as a whole as x. So, therefore, our new differential equation is d squared x over dt squared is equal to negative omega squared x. No? So, lipat lang natin sa kabila para maging general form. So, we have d squared x over dt squared plus omega squared x is equal to 0. This is our answer. Ayan. Okay, so, yun, no? So, that's how we solve this one. So, number 6 tayo. So, baba ko lang muna to number 7. Baba ko lang ha, wait lang. Nandito na lang. So, we have for number 6. Ayan. So, zoom na ako ulit. Oops. Ayan. So, number 6 na we have x is equal to a sine omega t plus b. So, we are asked to find, no? What is the differential equation to this function? So, let's eliminate the arbitrary constant. So, alam ba yung mga arbitrary constant natin dito? Obviously, we have a and b, no? So, omega is not an arbitrary constant kasi, ano siya, may value yan, no? So, yun. Next, we have, since dalawa, no? Dalawang beses tayong kukuha ng derivative natin in respect to t. So, we have dx over dt. This is equivalent to a, no? Multiply to what is the derivative of sine nu basically, that is cosine nu du. So we have the derivative of omega t plus b is omega, di ba? Kasi yung zero, yung b naman magsisiro yan. So we have omega a omega, okay, cosine ng omega t plus b. Okay, then kunin ulit natin kasi dalawa nga eh, di ba? So kunin ulit natin yung ating derivative. So we have d squared x over dt squared is equal to a times omega squared, no, times negative sine omega t plus b. So, katulad lang to nung kanina, no, yung sa cosine natin. Ang derivative ng cosine ay negative sine u du. So, du natin, inuna ko lang, no, yung omega squared. Tapos, ito yung ating derivative, no. Let's rearrange, no. So, para mas ma-recognize natin. Kasi, guys, hindi na naman natin na-eliminate yung dalawang arbitrary constant katulad kanina, no? So, we have to rearrange so that we can check ano ba yung mga pwede nating i-substitute. We have negative omega squared times a sine omega t plus b. So kung mapapansin niyo no, yung ating a sine omega t plus b, that is actually x no, katulad lang nung kanina, given siya. So pwede natin siya i-substitute, so therefore we will have d squared x over dt squared is equal to negative omega squared x. Then therefore, pag inayos natin, now we have d squared x over dt squared plus omega squared x is equal to 0. So this is our final answer. Ayan. Okay, isip ko lang. No, so, yun, ganun lang kadali kumuha ganun lang kadali mag-solve ng elimination of arbitrary constants, no? So, let's proceed with the last number. So, we have here number 7, no? Y is equal to C1 e raised to negative 2x plus C2 e raised to 3x, no? So, ganun, we have two arbitrary constants. So, dalawang beses ulit tayo magde-derivative. So, we have here y prime is equal to negative 2c1 e raised to negative 2x. So, katulad lang nung nauna natin, no? So, plus 3c2 e raised to positive 3x. Then, we have our y double prime. So, we have 4c1 e raised to negative 2x plus 9c2 e raised to 3x. So, ganun ulit, hindi na-eliminate, no, yung ating arbitrary constant na C1 and C2. And hindi na-applicable yung ginagawa natin doon sa example number 5 and number 6. Bakit? Kasi hindi na natin mafa-factor out to. Diba? 4 and 9 are not equal. So, hindi natin siya pwede i-factor out. They do not also have a multiple. Diba? Tapos, kailangan totally ma-factor out natin yung 4 and 9 para magamit natin yung y. So, instead, no, since hindi natin siya pwede gamitin, gagamit tayo ng solution sa systems of linear equation. Okay? Okay, so let's have our last problem, no? So, we have y is equal to, no? So, this is equal to y is equal to c1 e raised to negative 2x plus c2 e raised to 3x. Okay, so we have two arbitrary constants here. We have c1 and c2. So, meaning dalawang beses din natin kukunin yung ating derivative. So, we have y prime. No, kunin natin yung first derivative. So, c1 e raised to negative 2x will give us negative 2 c1 e raised to negative 2x plus 3 C2 e raised to 3x. Okay? So, yan yung ating first derivative, no? For the whole equation. So, next, we have the y double prime is equal to positive 4, kasi negative 2 times negative 2 is positive 4. C1 e raised to negative 2x plus 9c2 e raised to 3x. Okay, so kung titignan natin, no, hindi na nga natin ma-apply yung 5 and 6 kasi hindi na natin ma-factor out basically yung 4 and 9 kasi una, they are not the same. Pangalawa, they do not share same multiple na mas mababa sa kanilang dalawa. And kailangan parehas natin sila maialis para magamit natin tong y possibly or yung y prime, no? So instead of doing that, no, we will be using the solution to what? To systems of linear equation. So kung naaalala ninyo, no, sa inyong high school mathematics, diba tinuro na ito? So basically we'll just treat the arbitrary constants as if they are variables, no? So okay, game now. So, paano natin solve to? So, I will name this one equation A, equation B, equation C. No? Tapos, pipili lang ako ng dalawa. No? Pipili ako ng dalawa on first how what to use so that I can eliminate one. No? I need two equations so I can eliminate one variable. So, we have here, let's say, no, B and C. Let's say, no, B and C. Kopyahin ko na lang para sa pabilis. So we have, ayan, no? So equation B and C. So let's try to solve. So, ayan. Kailangan ma-eliminate ko isa sa kanila, no? Either si C1 or si C2. Pero dito sa case sa mas madali eliminate si C2, si C1 rather, kasi negative na yung isang side. So kahit positive na lang yung i-multiply natin. No? So I will multiply, no? Dito sa taas, I will multiply 2 para maging negative 4 yung C1 natin. No? So we have y double prime, pag pinag-add natin, no? Pag pinag-add, y double prime plus 2y prime. So, saan nagaling 2y prime? 2 distribute mo dito sa y prime. Diba? Then, this is equal to, dito naman, so cancel na to. And this one, kasi diba, negative 4 plus 4 is 0. Then, 3 times 2 is 6 plus 9 is 15. We have 15, C2 e raised to 3x. Okay, so, let's say, no, this is equation, ano letter na to? A, B, C, D, no, equation D, let's say. Okay, so I need another equation, no, so hindi ko na pwede gamitin si B and C na magkasama, pero I can use either, no, then gamitin ko si A. So, para mas madali, no, obviously, para mas madali, si ano na lang, no, A and B na lang ulit ang gagamitin ko. So, we have, oops, sorry. Ayan. Ayan, no? So, ito yung ating dalawang equation na gagamitin. Ayan. So, I will multiply again, no? Positive 2 dito sa first equation natin. Para maging 2 minus 2 is equal to 0. Diba? So, let's add, no? So, we have 2y plus y prime, or y prime plus 2y, no? Commutative naman yan, okay lang yon. So, ito naman ay makakancel. So, 2 minus 2 is 0. Diba? Then, we have 2c2 e raised to 3x plus 3c2 e raised to 3x is 5, what? 5c2 e raised to 3x. Diba? Ayan. So, we have equation letter E. Now, para ma-eliminate ka na, eliminate na natin yung C1, no? So, si C2 na lang yung problema natin. Gagamitin ko yung nauna ko na-solve kanina, si equation D, kasi di ko pa naman nagagamit to, no? To eliminate C2. So, copyin ko lang. Oops, hindi pa nakopya. Ayan. No, so, we have two equations here. So, game, let us simultaneously solve this one. So, I need to multiply ano dito sa taas? Negative 3. Diba? So, kailangan ko mag-multiply ng negative 3 para maging negative 15 itong 5c2 e raised to 3x. So, we have negative 3. So, we have here y double prime plus 2y prime. No? Then, we have negative 3 times y prime, that is minus 3y prime. Then we have 2y times negative 3, that is negative 6y, is equal to, obviously, 0. No, makakancel na kasi itong dalawa. Yan, na-eliminate na natin yung arbitrary constants. Okay, so simplify na lang natin, what is 2y prime minus 3y prime, that is negative y prime. So we have our final answer, y double prime minus y prime minus 6y is equal to 0. This is our answer. Okay, so, yeah, no, so that's it. That is the elimination of arbitrary constants. I hope you guys learned something. No, so, next meeting, we will be discussing how to solve initial problems and boundary, initial value problems and boundary value problems, no, involving differential equations. Okay, so, thank you. I'll see you next topic. Okay?